Hello everyone, welcome to Biznovate. I am Neeraj. There is a very famous saying by Mark Twain, if we cannot measure, it does not exist. So our today's topic is about goal management, which help us to track progress against our targets. In today's video of goal management, we are going to learn goals, goal matrices, Rollup queries, and other options. So let's jump to demo and see how it progresses. Let's start our demonstration of goal management. As you can see on my screen, we have sales department in which we have a sales manager and two salespersons. Sales manager Neeraj is working on opportunity 1 and 2, Steve working on 3 and 4, and John working on 5 and 6. Now I am going to show you goal management in software. So I am using Dynamics 365 Sales Hub. Let's go to opportunities, goal view. So you can see op 1, op 2 by Neeraj, op 3, 4 by John, 5 and 6 by Steve. So in total there are 6 opportunities, 2 of each. All 6 are open and they have some estimate close date and some estimate revenue. So all the 6 opportunities are open and none of them is closed. When I say close, either lost or won. So now we start working on goals based on these opportunities. Go to app settings. Go to goal. New goal. Sales in goal. I come to parent goal later on. Goal owner. For team level goal, I am assigning Neeraj as goal owner, who is the sales manager. When I say goal owner, means the person responsible for achieving targets as per the goal. Manager, it means the person who is managing the overall management of goals like editing, setting targets and etc. Now we go to goal metrics. By default, in goal metrics, we have 3 options. Number of product units, revenue and number of cases. These 3 options are available by default, which you can use as per your business requirements, and you can also make new goal matrices. Like for example, option 1 and 2 are more relevant for sales. Number 3 is more for the number of cases in the customer service. For this demonstration, I am using revenue. Under goal matrix or revenue, if I click on this one, save and continue. Name revenue, metrics type amount, amount type money, Rollup fields. Please see Rollup fields very carefully. So as I mentioned, we have 6 open opportunities. So when I say open, opportunity open. So we have estimate revenue and estimate close date. When we close opportunity as 1, we have actual revenue and actual close date. So you can see we have 2 Rollup fields. In case required, we can add more Rollup fields and remove in progress as well. So it all depends on your business requirement, what to keep, what to remove. So in this case, we have actual revenue and estimate revenue, actual close date and estimate close date. I go back to journal. Save and close. So we have discussed name, goal owner, goal manager and goal matrix. Time period. See, when we have time period, we have 2 options, fiscal period and custom period. If fiscal year is defined by your company, your organization, you can choose these options from here. In this demonstration, we are taking custom period. So this goal is for 1st June to 31st August. Targets. Let's assume we have target of $5,000 for the sales team. Child goals, I'm going to cover very soon. Actuals. Let me click on recalculate. So you notice that actual is 0, in progress is 1200. How come? If I go to journal, I can see owner is Neeraj. Neeraj have two opportunities, both are open and sum is 1200. As none of opportunity is closed as 1, it is 0. So now let me make some child goals. We have to use a John and Steve. As John is supposed to achieve this target, so it is goal of John, so I am assigning owner as John. Time period copied from the parent goal. Let's say target is again. Target again, 2000 for him. If we go back to PPT, we have mentioned that Neeraj is sales manager, Steve and John are salesperson. So collectively, all these three guys will work on opportunities and make the money for the department. So in sales team goal, we have two child goals, John and Steve. Now again I go to actuals, recalculate. Actual is 0, it is 4200. How come? It is sum of all these guys. Now we can explore more options. We have option over here, goal criteria. Roll up only from child goals. As of now, it is no. If I choose yes, it means it will only choose value from child goals, not from the parent goal. Let me save it. Recalculate. Refresh. Actuals. 3000. How come? Because in this case, child are John and Steve, and sum of all these are 3000. I hope it's clear so far. Now we have other option over here, all. When we select all in select setup for rollup and we save it, it states us please define the rollup query. So here in Neeraj we have two customer, Alex and Carla. Let's make new rollup query. Query for filter. So equal. records. Notice that in case of Neeraj, there are two customers, Alex and Carla. So if I say potential customer equals Carla, it give me a single row. Let me save and close. And let me choose query from here. Query for filter. And same here. So please notice that whenever I choose this option all over here in record set for Rollup, it asks me for queries and filter results by query. If I got to recalculate, refresh, I click on actuals. Now value is coming 3200. Why so? Because in case of Neeraj, now it only picking the record of Carla, is not picking the record of Alex. And 200 this one and 3000 this one, 3200. So I hope it's clear so far. We have discussed items in general tab, time period, targets, child goals, actuals, goal criteria. Now go back to next level. You notice that in actuals, actual money is zero. All is in progress. Reason being, all the opportunities are open. Let me close two opportunities. For Steve, one is closed, one is open, and he have achieved $1,000 out of $2,000. Same for John, one is open and one is closed. For now, to goals, recalculate, refresh. So Steve have achieved 50%. Steve have achieved 50% and John have achieved 25%. Reason being, actually is 500 and his target was 2000. So I hope it's clear so far. Now I go to my team goal, department goal. Here, 1500 we have achieved and 1700 is in progress. Let me remove this criteria, save it, calculate, refresh, actuals. You can see we have 1000, 1200, 1700, 2700 are in progress, and actual we have this much. And we have at goal level we have achieved 30%, reason being target was 5000. So I hope it's clear to all of you how to use goals, child goals, how to calculate actuals and in progress, what is goal criteria, and various other options. We also have option over here to show chart. So you can also refer this chart where it is showing how much Steve, sales team and John is standing in terms of the achievements. So I hope you like this demo. To see more demonstrations of this kind, please subscribe. Thank you.